Does Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala send us messages during the day and at night? Have you heard of a highway robber who became one of the best people in the world? Did you hear about a man who repented to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala after listening to a verse from the Quran? In our everyday lives, we see bad people. What is our duty toward them? We will answer those questions in this video, inshallah. All praise be to Allah and peace be upon Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. Today I would like to share with you a story about someone called Al-Fudayl ibn Iyad. He was an infamous highway robber. Imagine that he was a thief. In the middle of the night, he would prowl for victims on the road between two cities. Between these two cities was a small village where Al-Fudayl loved a girl. Al-Fudayl climbed over the wall of her house one night out of desperation to be with her. As he was climbing over it, he heard a voice recite a verse from the Quran. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala sent him this message. Bismillahir Rahmanir Rahim. Alam ya'ni lil-ladhina amanu an takhsha'a qulubuhum li dhikrillahi wa ma nazala minal haqq wa la yakunu kal-ladhina utul kitaba min qablu fatala 'alayhimul amad faqasat qulubuhum wa kathirun منهم فاسقون اعلموا أن الله يحيي الأرض بعد موتها قد بينا لكم الآيات لعلكم تعقلون. He heard Allah's message as if Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala was telling him to repent and correct himself. At this moment, Al-Fudayl understood the message and said, Oh my Lord, the time has come. After returning from where he came, he sought refuge near a traveling party on the main road. They were busy engaging in a serious discussion. Al-Fudayl heard one of them saying, Let's continue our journey now. Another one answered, No, not until the morning, for Al-Fudayl is lurking on the road somewhere out there just waiting to rob us. They were worried Al-Fudayl would rob them. That's what Al-Fudayl heard. He heard the entire conversation. So Al-Fudayl thought to himself, I go around in the night to sin while a group of Muslims remain here because they fear me. Indeed, I feel that Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala brought me here to them only so that I can reform my character. Oh Allah, I indeed repent to you. He understood that the time of repentance has come. Oh Allah, I indeed repent to you. From this story, there are moral lessons we should understand. The first moral lesson that we can learn from this story is that no matter how sinful a person is, there is always a chance that they may turn back to Allah in repentance. The second moral lesson, since we don't know people's futures, we should hope for their guidance. Sometimes the worst of people can become the best of people. So if we do something bad, we have to correct ourselves. If we see someone who does a bad thing, we should always advise him and wish good for him. Maybe we guide him to the straight path. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala help us all to correct ourselves and please Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. O Allah, forgive me, my parents, and the believers when the Day of Judgment will be established. والسلام عليكم ورحمة الله وبركاته.